Hello, my name is Greg Ju with Keysight Technologies here at IMS 2016. So today for 5G, we often think of 5G being equated with millimeter wave or maybe centimeter wave, but in actuality, there is research going on down below 6 gigahertz, what we call sub 6 gigahertz. And as you know, today within the 6 gigahertz spectrum, there is relatively little spectrum available. So this research is mainly geared towards investigating new types of waveforms that can use the spectrum more efficiently. And so what we'd like to do here in this demo is explore potential coexistence issues between candidate 5G waveforms and 3G, 4G PAN waveforms. So to do this, we're going to use our System View design software, which is installed on our M8190 arbitrary waveform generator embedded controller. So we have the workspace shown here, and in this schematic, we have various candidate 5G waveforms that are being simulated. So we have FBMC, filter bank multicarrier. We have GFDM, generalized frequency division multiplexing. We have OFDM, which we're all familiar with because of LTE, but there is also filtered OFDM that is being investigated. There is UF-OFDM, also known as Universal Filtered Multicarrier, or UFMC. And down below here, we have our 4G waveform, which is LTE. Each of these waveforms is being simulated. There are different signals at different frequencies, different bandwidths. And the key here is to use a signal combiner element, which basically is an arbitrary resampler. And it takes multiple input signals. It combines them together and resamples them, and the user specifies an output sample rate that they would like to see on that output waveform. And so that's what we've done here. We've combined the waveforms into a composite waveform that has been defined and configured for our M8190 AWG. So now what I'm going to do is go ahead and perform the simulation, and we're going to download the signal to the M8190 and take a look at it. Okay, we've downloaded the waveform to channel 1 of our AWG. Our arbitrary waveform generator is a two-channel AWG. So on channel 1, we're going to play our candidate 5G waveforms. This has been downloaded, and we have an external power splitter that's being used as a combiner at the input of our PXA. So we can see the resulting spectrum, and we have our GFDM signal. We have our FBMC signal, which has been notched. The middle subcarriers have been notched out. And within that notch, we've centered an LTE signal. And we're going to take a look at the coexistence of that LTE signal in the presence of FBMC in just a minute. We also have our UFMC signal, and we have our custom OFDM waveform. Okay, so for channel 2, we have a different schematic, and this schematic is our 3G, 4G, and PAN waveforms. So in the schematic, we have an LTE source, we have an edge source, we have a GSM and WCMA source, and we also have wireless LAN and Zigbee. Now, a key thing to note is that for LTE, edge, GSM, and WCMA, these are all simulation sources. In other words, they're all created within System View. But for wireless LAN and Zigbee, you'll notice that it's using our VSA software. And VSA software, typically we consider that analysis software. But in System View, there's also a VSA source. So what it allows you to do is capture signals with Keysight test equipment and read those captured waveforms or recordings back into System View. And so this is a key benefit here because a customer could mix and match between simulated signal sources and captured waveforms. Again, we're using the signal combiner to combine and resample the waveforms to create one composite output waveform. This is then downloaded to channel 2. And so now I'm going to perform the simulation and we'll download the waveform to channel 2 of our AWG. Okay, so our simulation is completed and we've downloaded the waveform to channel 2. So again, channel 1 is playing our candidate 5G waveforms. Channel 2 is playing our legacy 3G, 4G, and PAN waveforms. Both of these, are routed to this power divider. This combines the two channels, and we're showing the composite waveform on our PXA signal analyzer and displayed here. So from left to right, we have our LTE waveform. This is a different LTE waveform that we looked at previously at a lower frequency. We have GFDM, We have edge and GSM, and these are kind of popping in and out. We have our notched FDMC waveform, as we discussed previously, with the LTE signal parked in the center of the notch. We have our custom OFDM waveform, UFMC, and WSDMA. Now let's go ahead and we're going to use our vector signal analyzer software, or VSA software, to go in and demodulate the 3G, 4G, and PAN waveforms. And so here we're demodulating the 3G, 4G waveforms. We have edge being demodulated. We have our GSM waveform. We have the two LTE waveforms. And we have our WCMA waveform. So as you can see, the EVM looks pretty good for each one of these. And it's indicating that for this particular scenario, we have good coexistence between the 3G, 4G waveforms and our candidate 5G waveforms. So now let's take a look at a case where maybe the 5G waveform might be interfering with an LTE waveform. Okay, so here we've downloaded the waveform to channel 1, and this is with the narrower notch width for the FDMC waveform. And we can see now that the FDMC signal is starting to encroach on the LTE signal. So spectrally we can see this. Now let's take a look at the vector signal analysis software and see what kind of impact it has to EVM. Okay, so here is the resulting demodulation of that LTE signal centered at 2 GHz in the middle of the notched FDMC waveform. You can clearly see that the constellation has more distortion on it. You can see the spectrum, and kind of on the left and right edge of the spectrum, you can see the edges of the FDMC signal starting to encroach on the LTE signal. Here we are looking at EVM versus subcarrier, and so you'll notice that it kind of has a bathtub type of shape where on the edges the EVM is degraded as a result of the FDMC waveform encroaching on it. The key to this is the flexibility of the software combined with our test equipment in creating different signal scenarios. This could be used in an R&D environment to do what-if scenarios. It can also be used to maybe generate signals with different interference scenarios and run those into a receiver and see how that impacts the receiver performance. So with that, I'd like to thank you for your time. Please contact Keysight Technologies for additional information. Thank you.